Happy Saturday, everybody. We started off to a very foggy start to the morning with a dense fog advisory in the metro. This is our South Jackson Sky Cam around 7 o'clock this morning. You can barely see that tree lining right at the bottom of the screen. And there's that bright sunshine trying to penetrate through that fog. Again, that dense fog advisory in effect until 9 o'clock. This includes the metro over towards Smith County, up towards Itala County, Holmes, Yazoo counties, from Humphreys all the way down towards Warren County. Now, areas not included in this still seeing patchy fog this morning, but the visibility had been significantly reduced farther into the metro. It's been a while since we've seen that visibility of a quarter mile or even next to nothing like the metro over towards Kosciuszko and Yazoo City. That fog should be lifting by around 9 o'clock at the latest as temperatures go on up. Dew points are kind of helping that out, though. Temperatures and dew points right at the same temperature, so that's one of the reasons why we are seeing that fog out and around the area. Now, through the day today, that fog again should eventually fizzle on out, and we'll be left with partly cloudy skies as we head into the later part of the morning. Temperatures going from 73 by 9 into the 80s by lunchtime today. Overall, I am expecting a dry day, but there is the possibility of a few afternoon splash and dash showers and storms from Jefferson to Adams, Franklin down towards the Mid and Wilkinson counties. Temperatures this afternoon getting into the upper 80s, low 90s, real field values reaching the mid to upper 90s, but that heat only goes up from here. Wake up temperatures in the morning back into the upper 60s into the mid 70s. Partly cloudy skies continuing into tomorrow and highs in the mid 90s. But real field values 5 to almost 15 degrees above what the actual temperature is expected to be. This is going to be on the dangerous to very dangerous heat level. Heat advisory most likely going to be issued tomorrow, and that could continue into Monday and Tuesday at the least. And here's why. It's going to be a copy and paste with those temperatures for Monday and even into Tuesday. Highs in the mid 90s, real field values back into the triple digits between 103 and 110 degrees. This continues into next week as well, so those dangerous real fields not subsiding any. We do have the possibility of rain mid to late week. That may help some spots, but unfortunately not really going to help the entire region. So you know what to do when it comes to dangerous heat. Light, loose fitted clothing, lots of water, frequent breaks, and stay in the shade. If you can stay inside during the heat of the day from like 1 to 6, I think that's going to be the best option for you. Again, not much of a change when it comes to the next several days. Rain chances could pick up some mid to late next week.